The phenomena of climate change is quite an important phenomena to be taught to the student of Faculty of Business. Our lecture today is about climate change and poverty. From the beginning, it's quite important to know that as introduction, climate change is going to affect the developing countries and poor people differently compared to developed countries. And meanwhile, and at the same time, that women are going to be affected seriously by these phenomena. We have to start by defining climate change. With industrialization, emissions of greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide, have increased, and due to that, the temperature of the Earth has increased by this phenomenon. The impact of climate change on developing countries differs than developed countries. Why? Because developing countries will be more seriously affected by climate change due to their low adaptive capacity, their reliance on climate-sensitive sectors such as agriculture and fisheries. We all know that for developing countries and poor developing countries, they are relying more on the agriculture sector compared to other sectors of the economy. Poorer developing countries are most at risk since they are more reliant on agriculture and coastal and water resource change. We can take example of that by different continent of the Earth. Like in Africa, for example, many factors contribute and compound the impact of climate change and will have negative effect on the continent ability to cope with it. It includes poverty, illiteracy, lack of skills, weak institutions, limited infrastructure. All this is adding to the risk confronting Africa to address and to address the phenomena of climate change. For Asia is the largest continent on the Earth and spreads over four climatic zones. These zones can face severe and formidable environmental and socio-economic challenges by the phenomena of climate change affecting seriously poor people. The same can be done with, for Latin America. Latin America includes much of the world's biological diversity, and Amazon forest is representing a very important vulnerable to extreme climatic events. Climate change may have impact on poverty since it's predicted to deepen poverty directly and indirectly. The direct impact includes the loss of extreme events, when we have a flood, for example, and is going to have damages for lives, for houses of poor people, for plants. All this is affecting seriously poor people. The indirect effect is due to the effect on economic growth, like when we have the sectoral origins of growth, including the ability of poor to engage in non-farm sector, as well as increase inequality and to reduce the poverty elasticity of growth. From here it comes that the impact of climate change on poverty. If we refer to the Millennium Development Goals, for which having one of the major goals is to combat poverty, we can see that during the period from 2005 to 2015, few countries have succeeded to address the goal of combating poverty, like China and India. Most developing countries, specifically in the African continent, have failed to achieve such millennium goals. Now we are moving to the gender dimension of climate change. In the gender dimension, we are asking a very important question. Did the phenomena of climate change affect both men and women on the same the same size of impact, and you know, we have to, the answer for this question is that despite that climate change affects everyone, it's not gender neutral, which means that climate change magnifies existing inequalities between men and women, and increasing the vulnerability of women, because women and men are affected differently by natural hazards and environmental stress, because of the differences in traditions, in roles and responsibilities, and in the gender specific roles that affected women differently compared to men. Now we are moving to the phenomena that we know quite well, that climate change is affecting women differently than men. And then the second question regarding to the climate change and women's poverty. We are going to address a phenomena regarding women and poverty, which is the phenomena of feminization of poverty. Feminization of poverty means that we can find that women, the percentage of women that are suffering from poverty, mostly in developing countries and in poor communities, are going to be higher than that for men. This is the explanation of feminization of poverty. And since women are suffering from poverty more than women, than men, we have to address the challenges of poverty of women properly enough to combat poverty for any developing country. Climate change has serious ramifications in the dimensions of food security. This is quite important for developing countries, specifically African continent, and we have to take it into consideration, as the dimension of food security includes include food availability, food accessibility, food utilization, and food systems stability. Now we are moving to how to respond to climate changes. What actions should be taken by government, by civil society, in order to address climate change? And we are going to take also the gender perspective of that. We have two very important expressions that we have to understand the difference between them and to know the explanation of each expression. These two expressions are mitigation and adaptation. So we are going to start by that developing countries have limitation in capacity making adaptation difficult. So we are going to start by adaptation. What is the meaning of adaptation? Adaptation is actually addressing the results of the climate change, which means that for the climate change is having detrimental effect on the society from different perspectives. So when we are making programs of adaptation, it means that we are making action plans and policies in order to address the impact of the phenomena of climate change. So if we are going to have, for example, a shortage of water as a result of the phenomena of climate change. So adaptation means that we have to move towards water desalination. We have to move for all activities that may save water, either in agriculture or for consumption use. So this is means that we are making adaptation interventions, which actually should be affected by the situation of every country. But mitigation is But mitigation is completely different. Mitigation is, in fact, considering the reasons of climate change. Mitigation is addressing the reason of the climate change, which means that if the reason is burning fossil fuels, so instead of referring to fossil fuels, we are going to what is called renewable energy. So we are going to generate energy from solar, for example, from winds, from biomass. All these are examples about addressing the cause of the phenomena, which is specifically emissions. In table 3, you are asked to compare and contrast mitigation and adaptation. We have to refer to how to compare and contrast by referring to the time, for example, for mitigation, the impact for activities regarding mitigation and adaptation. So you are asked as a student to have a clear picture and clear ideas regarding how to compare the main differences between mitigation and adaptation. One point is related to how we can be gender sensitive, how to respond taking into consideration the gender perspective. This topic is related to two main ideas. We first started by mentioning that women are going to be affected differently than men. Women are going to be affected more seriously than men. This means from the government and the civil society, it means that we have to address women differently. We have to take into consideration the gender perspective of the phenomena of the climate change. So this is from one perspective. From another, we are asking the question, can women play a significant role in mitigation and adaptation? We need efforts in mitigation and adaptation. The question mark, to how extent women can participate in active mitigation and adaptation. So the main topics that we have to address here, how women can raise their children, taking into account the phenomena of the climate change, how women can be a part of technological advancement related to climate change, having an active role in doing that, how women can work in awareness, enhancing awareness of people about the phenomena and how to address the phenomena, how women can play a significant role in consultation and in research that may help to mainstream climate change in our economic planning, in our action plans that may achieve both mitigation and adaptation efficiently enough.